ओके ओके पैराबोला वी आर डूइंग पैसेजेस एंड पैसेज वन व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन वी हैव अ पैराबोला देयर आर थ्री पॉइंट्स द नॉर्मल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट एट अल्फा कॉमा बीटा ओके लेट अस से द नॉर्मल हियर That's the normal here and the normal here. Okay, this is alpha, comma, beta. These are P, Q, R. Okay, and the parabola is y equal to 48. Now they are asking what is the centroid of triangle PQR, what is the ortho center of triangle PQR, and what is the circumcenter of triangle PQR. So I'll take this as T1, this as T2, and this as T3. One thing is T1, T2, T3 are the roots of you take the general normal and substitute it. What is the normal? Tx plus y is equal to ATQ plus T8. Okay. So T1 comma T2 comma T3 are roots of in the place of x, I have to substitute alpha. In the place of y, I substitute beta. Equal to 82 plus 28. Take everything to that side. We'll get 82 plus 2a minus alpha into t minus beta equal to 0. For this, there are the roots. We can find t1 plus t2 plus t3 is minus of 2a minus alpha. Sorry, 0. T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1 is 2A minus alpha by A. And T1 T2 T3 is beta by A. Leave that. If you know vertices of a triangle, you know how to find centroid or the center, like in first year, how we do it the same way. I think we are seeing some glare on the board. Try to manage if somebody is not, some part is not visible to you, I'll explain. I want to find T1 square plus T2 square plus T3 square also, which is T1 plus T2 plus T3 whole square minus 2 times T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1. T1 plus T2 plus T3 is 0 and this is 2A minus alpha by A. So 2 times alpha minus 2A by A. Okay, write this, then centroid is somewhat easy, or the center circumcenter will take a little time. Okay, can I erase this? Anybody needs more time? Okay, basically we have a triangle PQR. This is 81 square comma 281. This is 82 square comma 282. This is 83 square comma 283. I want to find two altitudes. If at all I want to find all the centers. First I'll finish centroid. But anyway, the slope of the chord joining Q and R is 2 by T2 plus T3. So that I will know perpendicular slope and find the altitude, let's say PN. Okay, so first of all, centroid. AT1 square plus 82 square plus 83 square by 3. 2a into t1 plus t2 plus t3 by 3. A common by 3 common. T1 square plus t2 square plus t3 square, we already got 2 into alpha minus 2a by a. And this is g. By a. This A and this A is getting cancelled. So 2/3 of alpha minus 2A comma 0. This is centroid. Okay, I'm going to erase this down part. Is it okay? This coming Sunday you have exam, right? Okay, same syllabus as last time. Whatever is supposed to be kept last Sunday, that one, that exam only, right? Advance, yes. So slope of QR is 2 by T2 plus 2,3. So slope of PL is minus of T2 plus T3 by 2. And the equation of PL, T2 plus T3 into X plus 2Y. I can substitute 81 square here, 281 here. That is a t1 square t plus a t1 square t3 plus 4at. Similarly, equation of qm, t3 and t1. So t3 plus t1 into x plus 2y. It is a cyclic order. A t2 square t3. A T2 square T1 plus 4A T2. When I solve this, I will get cancelled. X into T2 minus T1. I will get cancelled, and here I can take from this and this, I can take A T1 T2 common. I will get a T1 minus T2. From these two, I can take a T3 comma, which is T1 square minus T2 square plus 4a T1 minus T2. Okay, centroid is easy, but orthocenter will take less effort. How you do in first year 1B, orthocenter, same process. We will find slope of the sides, from that we will get slope of altitudes, and we will find equation of two altitudes and we will solve them. And we wrote one altitude only, we can by symmetry understand what how the other altitude equation looks. No, for other center we don't have any method, but we just do this. Okay, up to centroid part, everybody completed? SS2 is quite similar to this. Later on, I will talk about this. I will not do it, but I want everybody to try SS2 today itself. Don't delay it. Okay, so everywhere I can get T1 minus T2 common. Here T1 minus T2 is there, this is there. T1 square minus T2 square also I can get T1 plus T2 into T1 minus T2. But here T2 minus T1, so we will get a minus. So I will get minus x is equal to here a common. Here I will be left with T1, T2. From this I will be left with T3 times T1 plus T2 plus 4e. But what is T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1? This one. What do we get? This T1 T2 plus T2 T3. Oh, this upper part you are not able to say. Minus x equal to, after cancelling T1 minus T2 everywhere, A T1 T2 plus A T3 into T1 plus T2 plus 4A. Here, if I take A common, it is T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1 plus 4A. This is alpha minus 2A by A. Is it correct? Or 2A minus alpha by A? Okay. This is 2A minus alpha by A plus 4A. I can cancel A and A. I will get 6A minus alpha. And minus that side of x is equal to alpha minus 60. What about y? I have not found y. So this x value I have to substitute in back any one of them and find y. It is going to look lengthy. Oh, one more thing, just a small thing. I would have done one very simple thing here. If you have not copied, I am going to do fresh. In the place of T2 plus T3, what I can write? Minus T1. Then this equation is a little easier. So location you wanted little easier, so I am making it little easier. Okay. So this is T1 by 2. In the place of T2 plus T3 I can write minus T1. Just the calculation will become little simple. So I will erase this part. We will get same answer. Answer will not change. Just the expression may look little more comfortable. T1 by 2 means equation is T1x minus T2y. I want to substitute AT1 square comma 2AT1 here. So this will be AT1 cube माइनस फोर ए टी वन, और टी टू एंड टी थ्री आर नॉट गोइंग टू कम इन दिस इक्वेशन देन, ओके. स्लोप इज टी वन बाई टू एंड टी वन इज माइनस टू ए, पुट 81 स्क्वायर हियर 281, ओके. देन क्यूएम एल्टीट्यूड विल बी टी टू एक्स माइनस टू वाई इक्वल टू ए टी टू क्यूब माइनस फोर ए टी टू. नाउ व्हेन आई सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस आई विल गेट एक्स इन टू टी वन माइनस टी टू, वेयर ए इंटू टी वन क्यूब माइनस टू टू क्यूब माइनस फोर ए इंटू टी वन माइनस टी टू. टेक यू माइनस बी क्यू फॉर्मूला आई कैन यूज, आई विल गेट एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू टी वन स्क्वायर प्लस टी टू स्क्वायर प्लस टी वन टी टू माइनस फोर ए, ओके. बट हियर वी एक्सपेक्टेड टू गेट टी वन टी टू प्लस टी टू टी थ्री प्लस टी थ्री टी वन. Either way, it's coming same, but after getting x, finding y may become easier from this equation, may not be, okay. So by writing this as t1, it did not help so much, maybe, but I have to write this in terms of t1, t2, t3, t3, t1. I can write this as t1 plus t2 whole square minus 2 t1, t2 also. I have to just prove this is same as the negative of this. If I take t3 common from this, I will get t1 plus t2, and I can write that. Okay, either way it should be okay, but anyway, since I wrote earlier. Okay. So, I have to prove this is same as minus of t1 t2 plus t2 t3 plus t3 t1. Okay, so how to do this is t1 plus t2 plus t3 is 0. So, I can write t1 plus t2 is minus t3. Both sides multiply t1 plus t2. T1 plus t2 into t1 plus t2 equal to minus t3 or into t1 plus t2. If I expand this, I will get t1 square plus t2 square plus 2 t1 t2 is minus t1 t2 minus t2 t2. One t1 t2, if you send that side, we will get t1 square plus t2 square plus 2 t1 t2 is equal to one t1 t2 that side, we will get a minus of this t1 t3. T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1. Okay, so we can substitute that anyway. If you want, this is minus of okay, just we'll leave it this now and put that here. We are getting x is equal to A into minus of T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1 minus 4A. Minus a into t1 t2 plus t2 t3 plus t3 t1 is 2a minus alpha by a minus 4a. A will cancel, you will get alpha minus 6a. That's okay, but we have to find y coordinate. So this one I have substituted here and find y. I don't think by writing this slope it benefited us so much, but it's okay. Same number of steps only earlier also we took to get alpha minus 6a, but what about y coordinate, so it's fine. If I put this x here, I will get putting this better or this better, I put. If I put this, I will get t1 cube get cancelled, t2 square t1 will come, and t1 square t2 will come. Okay, I'll try to put this x here and see what will come by after we finish. Okay, finish this down part and then up to here. Of course, basically, you know what are we doing? You know, vertices, three vertices of a triangle, we are finding the slopes of the sides, then we are finding slopes of altitude, then we are finding equation of altitude, and then trying to solve them to get all those symbols. I want to substitute this x here and see what will come y. So t1 into a into t1 square plus t2 square plus t1 d2 minus 4a minus 2y equal to a t1 square minus 4a t1. So expand this, I'll get a t1 cube. A T1 T2 square, A T1 square T2 minus 4A T1 minus 2Y equal to A T1 cube minus 4A T1. Minus 4A T1 got cancelled, A T1 cube got cancelled. From these two I can take A T1 T2 common, I'll get T1 plus T2 equal to 2Y. But this is a minus 3. So A T1 T2 into minus T3 is 2. And what is T1 T2 T3? Beta by A. Yeah. So this is minus A into T1 T2 T3 is beta by A is 2. A will cancel. So Y coordinate is minus beta by 2. So finally ortho center x coordinate is alpha minus 6a, y coordinate is this. So h ortho center is alpha minus 6a comma minus beta by 2. Okay. So anybody want to give? ఎవరండి? నేను కొద్దిగా క్లాసులో ఉన్నాను, కొద్దిగా 10:30 to 11 మధ్యలో చేస్తారా? ఓకే. ఎనీబడి వాంట్ టు అలఫి, కెన్ యూ హియర్ మీ? ఓకే. Anybody want to give an idea how to find, we know centroid now and ortho center now, how to find circumcenter? Yeah, that is better than really finding perpendicular, bisector and solving, or SA equal SD equal SC. We can do that, but if you already found circumcenter that way, ortho center will do HD is to GS is to S1, or when we found ortho center this way, circumcenter will use that. Okay, HD is to GS is to S1 is better. Okay, we know h3 is to g s is 2 is to 1 and we want to find circumcenter. Anyway, based on 2 is to 1 ratio, we can write 2 s plus h by 3. If you rearrange it, s will come 3 z minus h by 2. So, circumcenter, 3 times centroid. For the centroid x coordinate I got (2α − 4a/3) minus orthocenter's x coordinate is (α − 6a)/2. Second, 3 times centroid y coordinate is 0. Ortho centers y coordinate is -β/6/2. Three three will cancel. 2α − α is alpha. -4a + 6a is +2a/2. And this is β/4. Okay, those are completed, can try passage 3. Okay, everybody completed? Okay. So please try passage 2, quite similar to this. I will even tell you what is this. Everything is same. Alpha, beta, everything is same. Instead of asking triangle PQR, centroid and all, they asked at P you draw one tangent, at Q you draw one tangent, at R you draw one tangent. They will form one triangle. For that, what is the orthocenter, circumcenter and the orthocenter? You know their vertices, you know their slopes. You can actually do the similar process. After getting the answer in terms of T1, T2, T3, you have to substitute in terms of alpha, beta and A. And passage 2 is a little more easier in terms of solving equations wise compared to passage 1. Okay, passage 3. What is the overall question of passage 3 is, there is a parabola. This question, similar question can be asked in circles chapter, ellipse chapter, hyperbola chapter also. What is this question? There is a parabola and there is a point A somewhere here, point A. Through that you can draw many secants. Every one of them is intersecting at P and Q here, P and Q here. and pn2 here, like this. Okay, now somewhere on this line there will be another point. I don't know what the name they gave. They gave BC and then P. It's okay. All right. So P and Q. This is B. This is another time. This is B and this is another time. This is B and this is. Okay. So through point A, which is out, this is point. Draw many chords. Identify a point P on this such that AB length, AP length, and AC length are in AP. AB length, AP length, and AC length are in AP. Similarly, P here, where AB length, AP length, AC length are in AP. So every time, you can identify a P where AP length is average of AB and AC. What is the locus of that P? Almost similar question. AB length, AP length, AC length are in geometric progression. At that time, what is the locus of P? Or they are in harmonic progression. What is the locus of P? These are the three questions. Let us see if it is circles chapter question, what would have been the answers without writing much of coordinate geometry. You take a circle, take a point A, draw many chords. This is B, this is C. 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 Every time I want to choose a point P, okay, such that this length, this length, this length are in AP, this length, this length, this length are in AP, this length, this length, this length are in AP. What do you think will be the locus of P? Anybody want to comment? In circle, stop. Yeah. Okay, anything more about that circle? A and P, which P? Yeah, you take the center of the circle. Whenever these are in arithmetic progression, this is the midpoint of the chord. The angle in a semicircle is 90. Okay, right? So the required locus of P is a circle with A and the center of the given circle is n of diameter. What if AB length, AP length, and AC length are in geometric progression? At that time, P is not the midpoint. P is somewhere. Don't even know where it is. So that AB length, AP length, and AC length are geometric progression. Anybody want to comment on what is the locus of P? I hope AP condition everybody clear. When you say AP, indirectly P is midpoint of B and C. So that's why, because it is midpoint of a chord, the locus is a circle with this point and the center has nth of diameter. What if AB length, AP length, and AC length are in geometric progression? Only in circles lesson we can do that easily. Other lessons we cannot do that easily. Geometric progression case. Locus of P will be pair of tangents. How can it be? There are a lot of P's in between, na? For this chord there is a P. For this chord there is a P. Do you think all these points are on the pair of straight lines? Okay. AB, AP, AC are in geometric progression. What is the locus of P? I thought somebody will tell just one step only. Answer very easily. And anything more? It bisects, it intersects the circle orthogonally. That's good. Why you want to say that? length of tangent will be radius, not diameter. Yes. Power theorem. We know AB into AC is AT square based on geometric progression. But we know AB into AC is, if it is tangent AT, AT square is equal to AP square. Even though position of P is changing, every time AP length should be same as AT length. So this AT length, this AP length, this AP length, this AP length, all are equal. You take this length of tangent as a radius and draw a circle with A as the center. That is the required circle, and it is a circle with center A and intersecting this orthogonally also. Is everybody clear the GP part? Okay. HP part may be difficult to conclude, but in higher level in geometry, it is a very simple point. Right now, we don't have to worry about the proof. I will prove by coordinate geometry only. When you take different card, every time identify a point P such that AB length, AP length and AC length are an harmonic progression, then the locus of that is nothing but the chord of contact of A. Okay? Not just a circle. Circle, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. I can even tell another way. They were the same thing. You take an ellipse, take one point, draw two tangents, draw chord of contact. When you take any other chord like this, if this is A, this is B, this is C, this is C. Every time AB length, AP length and AC length will be in harmonic progression. The locus of that P is the chord of contact or polar. Okay? That is not easy to prove from the figure. You have to prove by coordinate geometry. But at higher level, there are other ways to prove it. We don't have to get into that. But without knowing all these things well before, we can do by first year parametric forms. So we are going to do that way. But I'll give you some other idea also. What is that? Even though figure is like this, but I'll take like this. Let's say we have a parabola like this, and this may not be x-axis, don't worry. There is a point, I want to draw one chord whose inclination is theta, this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay. What is that I have to find? Through A, I have to draw a chord. It intersects the parabola at two points. I have to find AB length, AC length. Based on the arithmetic progression or geometric progression or harmonic progression, I have to find AP length and find the locus of that P. Somehow find P. Okay. So let B is equal to C is equal to, or B comma C are in the form of this question A, they gave minus 1 comma 1. I can do in general also. Okay. They gave here minus 1 comma 1. So, minus 1 plus r cos theta, minus 1 plus r sin theta. Or plus 1. X1 plus r cos theta, y1 plus r sin theta. That formula I used. I want this point to satisfy the parabola equation. Okay. This point should satisfy parabola. Should satisfy parabola. Okay, so y square equal to 4x. If I substitute this, 1 plus r sin theta whole square equal to 4 into minus 1 plus r cos theta. Expand this, bring it one side, you will get r square into sin square theta plus r into minus 4 cos theta plus 1 r here also. Okay. R into 2 sin theta minus 4 cos theta plus the constant is 1 here and 4 here, 5 equal to 0. Okay, for this, the roots are AB length and AC length. Roots of this equation are AB comma AC. At least for doing this question, you don't have to know anything about parabola. This question can be asked in first year in straight line chapter because all based on parametric form. The curve is a parabola or not, doesn't matter. We just have to call it by some curve. Okay, so I took a general point on this line. substitute in the parabola means obviously I'm trying to find B and C. I got a quadratic equation in terms of R. One R will give me AB length, another R will give me AC length. Now I have to take three questions separately when there is an arithmetic progression and all that. Okay. Let